Here we want to move volume to break variable, and then exam scores to summary of variables. So go ahead and click OK, and then we'll go back to our data editor window. And now you can see here, we have the mean, 84.9, repeated over and over for each value in the first group. So the mean of group 1, or no volume, is 84.9. And then we have the mean for the second group, or high volume, of 77.5, and SPSS repeats that for each observation, which can come in quite handy. So now I want to find the difference score, or in other words, take the score for a person and subtract the mean from it and find that difference. And I'm going to have that put in this column here. So to do that, we go to transform and then compute. And then here I'm going to make a new variable, which I'll just shorthand here and call diff for difference. And that will be equal to exam score, this value here. So double click exam score, SPSS puts it over here, type in a minus, and then we're going to subtract the mean, which is given in exam scores mean. So go ahead and double click on that. Then you should see here exam scores minus exam scores mean. And I'll go ahead and add some spaces there so you can see that minus sign a little better. Go ahead and click OK. And let's go back to our data editor. And now in our difference column, or diff, we can see the difference score. Or we have 84 minus 84.9 is negative 0.9. 80 minus 84.9 is negative 4.9, and so on. If we sum up these values, they will equal 0. To back up for a moment, while this is a measure of variability, notice this tells us how far a score varies from the mean of 84.9. This value varies from the mean of 84.9 by 4.9 points, and it happens to be below the mean because it's negative. 80 is 4.9 points below this value. And that's all this difference column reflects. But because these add up to 0, we need to do something to get rid of these negative values. And what Levene's test does is it takes the absolute value of these values. In other words, it makes it so that every value is positive, and then it works on those values. So let's go ahead and calculate an absolute value of each of these values first. And we'll do that by going to Transform, Compute Variable. And then here let's click Reset so it clears everything out. And now I want to make a new variable, which I'll shorthand as abs for absolute value, and then diff, so the absolute value of the difference score. And the way I can do that is I'm going to use the absolute value function in SPSS. If I click under function group on arithmetic, double click on that, and then select abs for absolute value, notice it says here, returns the absolute value of numeric expression, which is whatever's in the parentheses here, which must be numeric. Okay, so let's go ahead and move our variable here, diff. Notice it's selected here, so double click diff, and it'll put that in there. So we're getting the absolute value of the difference scores, or the absolute value of these values here in this column. So that looks good. Go ahead and click OK. Go back to our data editor. Notice here now you should see that we just have positive values. So in other words, the negative values are now gone and they're replaced with positive values. Or we took the absolute value of all those scores. Now Levene's test works on these values. Levene's test performs an ANOVA on the absolute value of the difference of the scores from their respective group mean. Now that's quite a mouthful, but that's exactly what it does, and that's what we just did ourselves. We found the absolute value of the difference scores of each score, how far it is from its respective group mean. Okay, that's what this column is. Now the only thing we haven't done is run the ANOVA on this yet. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll do an ANOVA on these values. This will be our dependent variable. Okay, so go to Analyze, Compare Means, and then One-Way ANOVA. And then here we're going to kick out exam scores. We don't want exam scores anymore. Instead, we want absolute value difference. So we'll move that over and then click OK. And then here, I'm going to delete just a few things here so we can line up these two tables and take a look at them. Notice the two tables I have selected here. This was the homogeneity of variance table from our earlier ANOVA. And then here's our ANOVA on the absolute value of the difference scores. And notice our F here of 0.078 and the p-value of 0.783. Notice how these two values match up exactly with the values in our test of homogeneity of variances table. We have our Levene of 0.078. You can see that down here. And we have our p-value of 0.783, which you can also see down here in the ANOVA table. And the same degrees of freedom of 1 and 18, which we can see in our ANOVA table. So this demonstrates that the Levene test is in fact an ANOVA, or an analysis of variance, on the absolute value of the difference scores. In other words, the difference between each score and its respective group mean. So that's it for Levene's test. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of a better idea of what it is that Levene's test is assessing when it's run in either the t-test or the ANOVA. This concludes the video on the Levene's test of equality of variances in SPSS. Thanks for watching.